has been a thorny issue that had left the political divide, especially the ruling coalition Kenya Kwanza, split down the grain. Trade CS Moses Kuria giving ultimatum to farmers over the disposal of their maize while warning the government would soon import maize. Sentiments that were subsequently dismissed by Agriculture CS Mithika Linturi and Prime Cabinet Secretary Musalia Mudavadi.
Ikifika siku ya Jumanne, tuko na mkutano ya baraza la mawaziri, nitapewa mwelekeo. Nikipewa mwelekeo tufungulie, tutafungulia. So mko na masaa karibu 72 ya kutoa mahindi.
I am not aware of what Kuria sent, and I don't take what I find it on social media as anything that is worth responding to. Be forced to sell your produce. So you will sell when you think is necessary and when there is need. Because I am the custodian of the statistics on how much food we require in this country.
Leaders from Western and parts of Rift Valley had already warned against the importations. Perhaps this could have formed the basis of the cabinet sitting Tuesday, chaired by President William Ruto, and resolving to postpone the importation of maize. A dispatch to newsroom says, and I quote, with this year's crop estimated to yield about 30 million bags of maize, in honor of our nation's sacred duty to our farmers, the cabinet resolved that the farmers' produce will be accorded priority access to the market. The government has, however, said they will be importing duty-free maize as from February to bridge the deficit of about 15 million bags of maize arising from the lower than expected domestic yields. It is, however, not clear if the maize they intend to import in February will be organic maize or GMOs, as Trade CS had already hinted to both. However, the courts halted the importations of any GMO product until a case filed by Kenyan Peasant League is heard and determined.
Kuingizwa kwa mahindi za GMO ama vyakula vya GMO katika nchi ya Kenya. Mahakama imekubaliana sisi, tunashindwa ni kwa nini serikali inaagiza GMO kutoka nchi za nje ilhali hapa Tanzania, hapa Uganda, Afrika Mashariki kuna mahindi ya kiasili ambayo ziko tayari kuingia Kenya.
Cabinet has pronounced itself on the position of GMO. So it's not something we can discuss. So if there will be need to bring GMO, miss won't do it.
At the same time, the government has maintained farmers will have access to fertilizer at a subsidized cost of 3,500, a move they say will boost food production and help bring down the overall cost of production and with it the rising cost of living. Meanwhile, the cabinet has resolved that they will forgo 1 month salary as their individual and collective contributions towards the ongoing state interventions on drought. Among other issues discussed include the Hustlers Fund, set to be launched Wednesday. Daniel Karioki, KTN News.